Hey guys, welcome to Kleeps Tech. We've done a lot of videos now installing AIO coolers, and we've gotten some few questions about whether or not to use your CPU fan, your CPU optional, anything like that. Could be pump fan one, could be pump optional, any of those. For the rest of the video, I'm just gonna refer to them as the optional header. We went through some manuals and we pretty much determined it doesn't really make that much of a difference. I always suggest reading your motherboard manual before building your computer because that'll give you a lot more information about your specific build than this generalized video will, but we're going to try to cover everything we can here. When using an all-in-one that has two connections, one for your fans and one for your pump, the general rule of thumb is to have your pump connected to your optional header and to have your fans, which usually connect to some kind of fan splitter or daisy chained, into your CPU fan header. Some motherboards will ask what kind of cooling solution you're using, and if you select liquid cooling or all-in-one or something like that, it will usually set the optional header to run your pump at full speed, which is what you want. It shouldn't make it any louder, and it moves the heat away from your cold plate faster. Then your CPU fan header should have some kind of preset fan curve, depending on your BIOS settings. Some motherboards like Asus will actually allow you to choose from a few different presets, but most people will just set theirs manually. Obviously, when you're setting your fan curves in your BIOS, the quieter you have your fan set, the higher temperatures you're going to see. But that also has a lot to do with your case. If you have a case with a terrible airflow, you're gonna have to set your fans to run higher to get those cooler temperatures, where if you have a case with a more decent, you know, better airflow, you can run them a lot quieter and still have the same temperatures because you've got more air flowing through your case. But that's more of a tech Jesus thing, so I'm gonna let him explain that. Some all-in-ones, like the Arctic Liquid Freezer 2, have both fans and the pump all using the same 4-pin connector, in which case you just plug it into your CPU fan header. Others will have some kind of USB connector that will require a USB header on your actual motherboard, and when combined with software, it can give you more information than just a 4-pin motherboard header will, as well as giving you much more control over RGB settings and all that. We also found that some motherboards, like Asus, won't even boot unless you have something plugged into your CPU fan header. We were installing a fanless cooler for a PC with no moving parts, and our Asus B450 Strix won't even allow us to get past the BIOS without changing a setting to tell it to not monitor the CPU fan. So when using Asus boards, I would definitely suggest having something plugged into your actual CPU fan header. There's also some difference in the actual power outputs in at least some higher-end boards. For instance, our Z690 Force from MSI has headers that can supply more power than other system fan headers found on the rest of the motherboard, with 3 amps at 36 watts versus the normal 1 amp at 12 watts found in most 4-pin headers. Both the mid-range Asus boards, as well as a Gigabyte Z690 we've checked, both only supplied 1 amp at 12 watts, even on the CPU fan and optional headers, and the ASRock manual didn't even give us a specification on the power draw for the headers. This honestly probably doesn't make much of a difference for the average builder, but if you're working on a custom water cooling loop or something like that, you theoretically could run a higher wattage pump on an MSI board or a higher end board than on a mid-range board, based on what we've read here. But thanks for tuning in, guys. We hope we cleared up the difference between the CPU fan headers and the optional headers. And if you found this content helpful, please consider subscribing so we can put out more content like this. And we'll see you guys next time.